Welcome. Before we begin the Mass, please adjust your cell phones to silent mode. This Sunday is the Feast of All Saints. On this feast, the Church celebrates the blessedness of all the saints and rejoices in God's promise of the resurrection. It is our hope that one day we will share heaven with the company of the saints and joyfully sing and enjoy the glory of God with them. In this Mass, we pray for all the needs of the members of our parish family and concerns of the whole world, for the Thanksgiving birthday prayers of Edgar de los Reyes, James Dompor, Victoria Hawkson, and Audrey L.A. Serrano, and the Thanksgiving anniversary prayers of Wilfredo and Amparo Caro. For all our brothers and sisters who need the grace of healing, and for all those who care for them. For our departed brothers and sisters, Teofilo and Virginia Toledo, Virginia de la Cruz Cristobal, Modesta Tanda, Noel Peñaflor Quicho, Edna Reverente, George Lau, Wilfredo Mercader, Bernardo Lopez, Paula Anderson, Joey Gutierrez, Romulo and Maria Questin, Maria Estela Questin, Gary and Alisa Paez Custodio, Melanio Mendoza, Silvestre Acosta Mendoza, Porfiria Amistad, Pantaleon Amistad, Kevin Sewell Mendoza, Rojas Acosta, Thomas Bedaña Jr., Lucy Daral Ungab, Cipriano Cruz, Rodora Trinidad Palencia, Leonardo and Belen Yap, Rufino and Edgardo Yap, Aldrin Puno, and all those who have died due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
Let us all rise and join in singing our entrance song, Table of Plenty, Breaking Bread, song number 311.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Happy All Saints' Day to all.
Happy All Saints' Day for
you too, Father.
In this celebration, we are being invited to remember the promise of the Lord through his death and resurrection, that even we die, we come to life, because in him there is no death. Enjoying life eternal is a communion of the saints with Christ and our God the Father to the outpouring of the Spirit. So to give our all in this celebration, let us be mindful that in the Lord we can find mercy and forgiveness. So let us now call to mind our sins. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you, for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation, I, John, saw another angel come up from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels who were given power to damage the land and the sea. Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God. I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal, 144,000 marked from every tribe of the children of Israel. After this, I had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne, and from the Lamb." All angels stood around the throne, and around the elders, and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen. Blessed and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes, and where did they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Upon the seas and established it upon the rivers. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord, or who may stand in his holy place? One whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain. Lord, this is the longs to see your face. He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Christ. Again, happy All Saints Day to all. I have no doubt all of us are very familiar of this day or of this feast. Why? Because this is, I would say, the goal of our life as Christians or followers of Christ. When God called us to holiness, and also when the Lord in his suffering, death, and resurrection gave us the ultimate gift of life, not temporal life, but life eternal. That in him, because he conquers death or conquered death, there is no longer death but life. So there are three things I would like to share with you in this particular feast. One, promise. Two, hope. And three, celebration. You may ask, why promise? What's in this celebration that we can think of a promise? If we have to go back to the readings, we can see the promise of this feast that Jesus offered to us, particularly in the Gospel today, when he was surrounded by the apostles sitting down, and he taught them about the life they have to embrace. We call this the Beatitude. He exhorted them to do something, and he offered them the promise. Like, blessed are the poor, for you will inherit the kingdom of God. So if we go into this, All Saints Day reminds us of the beautiful promise of the Lord to us. In following him, we can share the beauty and the life he has. We have to look at that in Christ, we know what suffering is. And we also know what resurrection is. In between is death. And he embraced it because he told us in 3 days he will rise again. The second is hope. The first reading from the book of Revelation is so vivid, or I would say it's really kind of picturesque, because it shows us how these holy people are being glorified in heaven. They were wearing white robes. They were kind of going around the Ancient One, the Holy One. And they were just glorious. Looking at this, the Feast of All Saints would give us a sense of hope. That if we continue and be truly children of God, we will be with him. With the promise, I hope we would be inspired to continue our own journey with Christ. Because one day, we can be among the saints. Just think that you would be, that we are one of those who are wearing white robes, washed by the blood of the Lamb. And the third, celebration. Here we can feel that it's truly a celebration. The music we are singing. I don't know if we are singing, only the counter is singing. We have the trumpet. It's so festive. Why? Because it's really a time of celebration. Because this is what the life of God is about. This is what the glory of God is all about. And this is what life eternal with God is all about. So looking forward of the promise in hope, we try to bring the glory of God in this celebration. And therefore, we have to celebrate. To feel the joy, to feel the Spirit, and above all, the gifts that the Lord gave us. The things that he asked us to do, no matter what. Because the reward is so great. The reward that we all know deserves a celebration. So hopefully, in celebrating this feast, we remember these things that we reflected on and move forward in our journey in following Jesus. Because the end of this journey is to be with him, counted to be among the saints. Let us all stand and profess our faith in one God. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism, forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us now come to the Father for our prayers and needs.
For the Church, that she may shine out as a beacon of hope in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For those in government, that they may always seek to build a society founded on justice in order to respect each person and help those who are poorest. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For those who serve sick people, that they may be strengthened in their care and expertise to bring about healing, and for those who are lonely, that this community may show them friendship. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For the Thanksgiving birthday prayers of Edgar de los Reyes, James Dompor, Victoria Jackson, and Audrey Ellis Serrano, and the Thanksgiving anniversary prayers of Wilfredo and Amparo Caro. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For our parish family, may we continue to support one another to grow in faith, hope, and love, and to build a welcoming faith family, the body of Christ, in this community. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For those who have died, Teofilo and Virginia Toledo, Virginia de la Cruz Cristobal, Modesta Tanda, Noel Penaflor Quicho, Edna Reverente, George Lau, Wilfredo Mercader, Paula Anderson, Joy Gutierrez, Romulo and Maria Cuistin, Maria Estela Cuistin, Gary and Alicia Paez Custodio, Melanio Mendoza, Silvestre Acosta Mendoza, Porfereria Amistad, Pantaleon Amistad, Kevin Sewell Mendoza, Roxax Acosta, Thomas Medania Jr., Bernardo Lopez, Lucy Daral Ungad, Cipriano Cruz, Rodora Trinidad Palesia, Leonardo and Belen Yap, Rufino and Edgardo Yap, Aldrin Puno, and those who have died due to COVID-19 pandemic, that they may rise in the glory of God with the company of the saints. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For our own personal intentions, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers. Together we pray, Lord God, through the sacrament of baptism, you give us new life and make us members of your living body, the Church. Grant, we pray, the stewards of your gifts and blessings,
we may responsibly support our permanent Church with great devotion, faith, courage,
and joy. To Christ our Lord. Amen. Mater Dei,
pray for us.
Of Dr. Rodel Lever and Bela Lever. May this offering we bring in honor of all the saints be blessing to you, Lord, and grant that just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for today you, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our Mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already give you eternal praise. Towards her, we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the church, through whom you give us in our frailty both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with the multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, defined of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and give it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. that the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching were there to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us show our smile of peace. Peace with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who take away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your saints, we implore your grace so that coming to perfect holiness and the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of your heavenly homeland. To Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our palace prayer, Almighty Father,
the body of Christ, the church,
is made up of people who believe in your Son, Jesus Christ, and said the suffering of your resurrection. Enable us to grow in faith, hope, love, and service.
And we will to welcome a friendly faith community.
A community that is your Son's life and
mission.
After the life example of Mary, Mother of God, Mother Dei, to the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mater Dei,
lead us to your Son, Jesus. Amen.
Please be seated.
Thank you so much to all who participated in the celebration of the crowning of the Blessed Virgin Mary in October. May the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Mater Dei, our Mother, always protect us all with her motherly care and love. Monday, November 2nd through November 10th, the Novena for All Souls will be offered here in our church. To include our dear faithful departed in this Novena of Masses, please write their names on All Souls Novena envelope and send it to the parish office. May all our faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Wednesday, November 4th, at 6:30 p.m., is our holy hour. This is a good time for us to spend an hour with the Lord, and the anointing of the sick will also be celebrated. To our parish family, we thank you for building our life of faith, stewardship, and sacrifice. We also thank all our friends and visitors in worshiping with us. It is our great joy to have you in this Mass.
Thank you all for gathering around your television for this particular Mass. And also thank you for all the ministers serving in this Mass. So let us remember that we are all called to be holy. Hopefully, when our time will come, we will be counted among the saints. It is the promise, our hope, and today we celebrate. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.